and smiling. My wife, a dear friend of mine, Robin Gardner. I was a percussionist in the chorus line. But I've known Jaime so long, I moved to BC, which is before chorus line. And we met, I took an audition for the American Symphony in 1972 for Leopold Sikorsky. I was a kid, I didn't know what I was doing. I ended up getting the job. At the end of the thing, I'm packing my stuff up. I'm sorry. I play the drums, I don't speak. It's easier in the back than make a record back there. So anyway, and the other thing is I'm packing my things up, and Jaime comes over. And with you know, all the sincerity, I don't have to go into who he is and what he is, because we all know how fabulous he was. And with the most genuine affection and support, he just said that was terrific, and could not have been more sincere. I was, just shaking Sikorsky's hand like Mickey Mouse was on the podium, and Jaime came over. I had this really unusual and fortunate experience of just crossing his path. Shortly after that, we spent 8 weeks together doing Bernstein's Mass in Washington and Philly at the Met. And then the following summer, having worked together most of the year before that, we shared a car together because we played all these parks concerts for about 6 weeks, everywhere from Co-op City to Staten Island, whatever. And we just had this unbelievable bond, having a great time. We couldn't have been more different. He was raising families with Chris forever. And I'm just a lunatic running around town. We had the best time just laughing with everyone. And to echo what Ben says, he was probably one of the most positive, fabulous people I know in terms of what he, just how he approached music, his love for it. He never had a bad word about it. And I remember it was 1 week. I needed three timpani. He had his bass in the back, two drums, and I needed a third timpani. So we spent the whole week with him with a big kettle on his lap, running all over the place and doing this. And, my driving was not so good then, it's not so good now, but all we did was laugh. And then we end up in chorus line. And if this was a vibraphone, Jaime was right here. And he was right there for 15 years, and we never had a crossword. You've heard me say this countless times, right? To everybody who visited the hospital. And it's remarkable, we all know how sometimes you get in these little situations. When I think back to the 15 years of chorus line, it goes by in a blur. And Jaime was always there, he was so professional in a way that with total ease, whatever. I do have some notes. But we ended up with this sort of, this effortless friendship that became sort of unstoppable via chorus line. One of the things, I'm just up here to tell a few anecdotes because the guy's probably one of the smartest, most talented people I've ever met. And we had this little quartet over in our corner. A wonderful guy named Roland Wilson, who played the Fender bass. He split the book when they came uptown. Jaime played upright, and piano player. The piano players changed over time, but we had this wonderful little group. So one day, I come into chorus line. I can't remember what year. You were there for 15 years, so God knows. I remember that Don Lippert was in that being. Jaime had forgotten his bow. I'm like, uh-oh, now he's such a pro, right? There's no bow. So we look around, and I'm all the way in the side of the pit there, but all this percussion stuff. We get a hanger. And a piece of rope, and it comes out something like this. I made this the other day. Believe me, this is precisely what we had. What he had, I'm already laughing. I have tears in my eyes. So he's got this thing, and now we're gonna play the show. Da 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 da. Of course, this is a big smash of rope. But thank goodness the pit is covered, and set up was the conductor couldn't see his bowing. It was a piano, and it was like a little mini celesta in the piano. The conductor's on the other side of that. Jaime's like, as if Jaime's got a bow behind his bow, he could not see. We're done. I mean, how I got to the show, me, Roland, I don't remember which piano player. And he's as serious. There's nothing to do here. He could have got down a forest of Christmas trees with the strokes he's going to use. It was probably foolish of me, but at some point we got into playing Scrabble at the end of the microphone. was raised in a family, and I thought, you know, so we, they took the scrambled egg away from us. We decided to get the scrambled egg, which was actually better. I never knew him. I never knew him in a prayer to him. But what I learned from just being next to him, he had this way of just making everything an absolute ball. When I was visiting constantly in the hospital, we just laughed. We just thought, I'm just telling all lots of stories. And you guys were hearing stories that you're looking like, my goodness. He's just a fabulous man. Just talking to some of his colleagues here, everybody has amazing stories to play, to say. At some point in my life, early in the course life days, I ended up contracting for PD Dubai for Peter Schilling, which I did for about 25 years. And he plays with Wilson, and Jaime's there. Don Palma played for many years. Don is here. And so one day, I came into the pit. I just got me an instrumentation for this particular series. I was doing Christmas. I said, Jesus, you know, what am I going to do? I need an accordion player for Peter Kimbach. He goes, oh, well, I play accordion. And Nick Archer, who's playing piano, goes, well, I have an accordion. So I said, that was it. So Nick comes by the next day with this little tiny little red accordion. It was perfect. It's like right out of some funny little red thing, one of those big things from Mars. Well, it was absolutely perfect. Jaime picks the damn thing up. I don't know when he would have played it last. And the next thing you know, he's on stage at Carnegie Hall playing accordion. And Peter got wind of Jaime's illness. I talked to his secretary, and Secretary Peter, a fabulous man, Peter Schilling, wrote him a lovely letter and mentioned the accordion in that letter, which I was really blessed to get to read to him, to Jaime, at the hospital. But not only did he play accordion, every other minute he played celeste, he played harpsichord, he played piano. One year he had like a little mouth organ on the keyboard thing, and next thing you know, Jaime was playing that a bit in the high side. I'm not supposed to talk too terribly long. I got a million stories here. But it was fascinating. I was blessed to know the man. We could not have been, in a way, more different, just how we were. But his extraordinary goodness of man is infectious. I love him forever. This was a guy we never went out to dinner. It's not like, oh, come on, between shows and have a beer. It wasn't about that. But he was one of the most positive, wonderful guys I've ever met. And I will cut it short. But having said, know that about the Catholic faith, just to wrap it up, it was interesting. We had just gotten the text about him transitioning, and I had not played St. Patrick's for well over a year. I played St. Patrick's too often with ensembles or whatever, and I don't know what compelled me, and it's interesting you say, but I said to my wife, I think I'm going to light a candle for Jaime, and so I went on a Wednesday night, when we got that, it happened to get the text, I went to the place, St. Pat's, and not a particular religious guy either, but I lit a couple candles, and it said, $2 for a candle. I had a $10 bill, so I put a $10 bill in there. And then the next night, we played the performance of Caribbean Requiem. Figure I had a credit of 3 candles. So I lit a couple candles, I said a few words to him, and they said there were no accidents, and it was peace, and he died the next day. And I could go on and on up there, I do have to get off, but I was just blessed to, every time I think about it, he was sort of right there, called for a million reasons. And every time I got the phone, he was right there. And it's hard to share that kind of time with somebody. And it was a love and a connection that I really can't explain, but I'm blessed. We're all blessed. And thanks for listening. I'll talk to the bass players if anybody wants to get in on this.